Hi, I'm Sahar Razavali, the author of the paper A Reliable and Energy Efficient RPL in Mobile IoT Applications. I've divided my presentation into 7 sessions. At first, I'd like to introduce the Internet of Things, and then a background of the routing protocol RPL and related works. Next, I'll introduce our purpose algorithm called Reefer. Next step, I'd like to show you system setup, simulation results, and conclusion. The Internet of Things is composed of an enormous number of devices that communicate with each other through the Internet without human intervention. Today, the Internet of Things is applied in different aspects of human life, such as smart cities, health monitoring systems, natural resource monitoring, transportation, and industry. In IoT, communication between embedded devices is in lossy environments. There are some problems due to limited resource devices and low bandwidth and unreliable communication links. For example, constrained processing abilities, low data rates, high packet loss, and frequent disconnection. According to prior research, routing is an important challenge in the IoT environment for reliability of communications, energy consumption, and response time for real-time applications. Different routing protocols are provided for the Internet of Things. An example of such protocols is the routing protocol for low power and lossy networks introduced by Internet Engineering Task Force. In routing, scenarios in IoT applications include static networks with stationary devices and mobile networks with static nodes and mobile nodes. RPL is an IPv6 routing protocol. It's a distance vector routing mechanism. RPL builds a tree-shaped graph with a single root known as DODEC. RPL has 4 control messages that could construct the DODEC graph with them: DIS, DIO, DAO, and DAOH. In order to establish the connection between the leaves and the sync node, RPL uses objective functions. The objective functions utilize different metrics for selecting the optimized path. There are 2 default objective functions in the structure of RPL: objective function 0 and MRHOF. Objective function 0 selects a path from one node to the root with the minimum hop count, and the MRHOF computes the rank of a node with the ETX metric and then selects the best parent based on the minimum rank. To manage the transmission of DIO control messages, RPL exploits the trigger timer mechanism. There are some disadvantages in RPL, lack of mobility support, which causes unstable network, reduction in the packet delivery ratio, and increasing control packet transmission. Another RPL disadvantage is the small neighbor table in dense networks. Therefore, due to the limited table size in the nodes, it's necessary to efficiently manage the neighbor tables. RPL explosion of the RPL explosions of node from the neighbor table regardless of the routing metrics. Interval timer, the long interval between DIO transmissions is not suitable for frequent updates on mobile networks. In this related works table, we have listed 5 works performed. As you can see, in previous work, the goal was to improve only one of the factors of reliability or energy consumption. But in our purpose algorithm, both of these factors are important. The solution consists of tracker timer, neighbor table, leak estimation, as well as node condition. In this session, I want to explain our purpose algorithm. Refer is an objective function to route packets in the mobile IoT environment. The replacement policy to manage neighbor table is LRU. We modified the tracker timer. We defined a threshold value for the maximum interval to avoid long interval between DIO sends. Refer filters the DIO messages from the mobile node in the stationary node to avoid congestion. In the parent selection mechanism, refer utilizes 6 metrics in order of preference, movement status, rank, distance between node and its candidate parent, ETX, ELTIP and RSSI. Refer has the threshold for ETX, ELT and RSSI in order to avoid changing the parent when candidate parents have almost equal metrics. There are 2 groups of nodes in terms of movement, stationary and mobile. In refer for selecting parents, the static nodes have the highest priority to be selected by each node in their path toward the sync node. The rank of the node is calculated according to the following equation. Refer would prefer to choose the node with the lower rank. The distance between one node and its parent is the third metric that is utilized in refer. So the candidate parent, which provides a shorter distance to the node, is more suitable for to the selected as the parent node. Expected transmission count, this metric shows the quality of the link between the node and its parent. The value of ETX is calculated as follows. If the difference between ETX values of 2 preferred parents for the particular nodes is higher than a threshold value, then the node with the lower ETX is selected as the best parent. Expected lifetime. This metric refers to the estimated amount of time for a node to be run out of energy. ELT equal to the total energy of node per the consumed amount of energy per unit of time by node. if ELT of one candidate parent is higher than the other candidate, then that candidate will be selected as the best parent. RSSI is unit of DP, and the candidate parent with lower RSSI is preferred. To evaluate refer, we have utilized the CUDA simulator in the Contiki operating systems. Mobility models are Gauss Markov, Manhattan Grid, Pararandom Walk, Random Walk, and Random Waypoint. And the rest of the simulation configurations are listed in the table. For instance, sensing area, number of transmitter nodes, number of sync nodes, and etc. The main goal of REFER is to enhance the reliability in mobile IoT applications. Reliability is calculated according to the number of successful packet deliveries from the total packet sent toward the sync node. REFER has improved PDR in different mobility models. For example, it has improved PDR in Gauss Markov by a factor of 4.6, in Manhattan Grid by a factor of 4.3, in Pararandom Walk by a factor of 3.1, in Random Walk by a factor of 3.4, and in Random Waypoint by a factor of 2.2 compared with NAOF. The reason is frequent update neighbor table based on the neighbor table replacement policy, LRU, and priority of stationary nodes over the mobile nodes in parent selection mechanism. There are trade-offs between PDR and energy consumption in an IoT infrastructure. REFER reduces energy consumption in 5 mobility models. In Gauss Markov, 7.2%. In Manhattan Grid, 3.47%. In Pararandom Walk, 7.43%, and in Random Walk 20%, and in Random Waypoint 22.85% compared with NAOF. The main reason, the reduction of retransmission and managing control packet exchange. In this objective function, there are a negligible amount of more packet overhead to the network due to selecting stable parents and reducing control packet. To summarize, we have shown the critical role of objective function in mobile IoT applications. Reliability and energy consumption are two important requirements in routing issues. The purpose refer to address these issues. The result of analysis demonstrates refer algorithm effectiveness in terms of reliability and energy consumption. Some of the references used in this study are given in these sessions. Thanks for your attention.